This is Annie. She's the star of a little reality show set on UC Berkeley's Campanile. And she did not come here to make friends. She's currently raising four chicks, which is nothing short of a miracle, because back in the 1970s, there were only two breeding pairs of peregrines in all of California, and none east of the Mississippi. But peregrines have made a big comeback. And now the world's fastest animal has moved into our cities and become a bit of an internet obsession. This is our new dad, Archie, feeding the kids. He's Annie's fourth mate since arriving at the Campanile. When her mate Lou disappeared in January, Annie spent a lot of time off camera. But then she was suddenly back and started chatting with a mystery guy just off screen. It was Archie. Dating isn't hard for Annie, since the Campanile is pretty prime real estate.
If someone had to ask me, where would you as a falcon pick to live in Berkeley? The answer would be the Campanile.
This is Lynn Schofield, the ornithologist who first discovered that falcons were living there back in 2017.
I'm the kind of person who sees a peregrine falcon and puts away my work and gets going to see what they're up to, right? Aren't you like that? Don't you see a bird and stop everything right away so you can go find it?
She runs the Cal Falcons Nest Cam together with her husband, Sean Peterson, an ecologist and UC Berkeley alum. Falcons love the Campanile because it's high up, away from any predators that might harm their chicks. It's got a great view of potential prey, and it's covered from the elements.
100 years ago, we didn't really see many urban peregrines. They were still out on cliff faces over oceans and over valleys. And this is all a story that goes hand in hand with coming back from the brink of extinction.
Peregrines were nearly wiped out in North America due to the widely used pesticide DDT. The chemical made their eggs thin, and when the parents sat on them, they'd break, which is just heartbreaking.
The most important thing for the peregrine falcon recovery program was the ban of DDT. It took, you know, some bravery on the part of the folks in the EPA to do that. We don't see bans like that happen as often anymore because there's a lot of special interests that want to continue to use these forever chemicals.
This is Zeka. She's the director of the UC Santa Cruz Predatory Bird Research Group. The group was originally founded in the 70s to help repopulate peregrines in California. For years, they hatched the fragile eggs in captivity and then returned the birds to the wild. Thanks to their work, peregrines were removed from both federal and state endangered species lists by 2009.
Peregrine falcons recovered really well, and we started to see them showing up on bridges, on buildings, you know, any structure that was, you know, over 60 feet tall, that had a good view of some foraging area, as well as their traditional cliff nests that they had occupied continuously for millennia.
But city living does bring some new dangers. Windows are the big one, especially the reflective ones that architects really love. The first year that Annie had eggs, one of their chicks hit a window and died. Since then, UC Berkeley has done a lot of work bird-proofing nearby windows. Cars are another big threat. Annie's longtime mate, Grinnell, was actually hit by one. And for any bird, the first few days out of the nest are the most dangerous time of their life. If they stumble during their first flight, they might end up on the ground. And in the city, that means possibly running into cars or dogs or people. But there is one thing that can help during this dangerous time.
Not to anthropomorphize too hard, but you know, really, Annie is a good mom. She has successfully raised so many chicks. And it is partially because she does an extended amount of care relative to a lot of falcons.
Typically, after a baby falcon's first flight, their parents stop bringing them as much food to encourage them to strike out on their own. Annie's chicks, on the other hand, tend to take a month or two longer to reach independence.
You know, she's had a chick that's like ready to fly or maybe has just flown for the first time, and she'll still chase them around with food. It's like this teenager being like, Mom, no, I don't need it. I can do it on my own. And she's like, here's another little bit of pigeon, honey. And she's always there caring for them. And it's really I think one of the things that makes watching the camera so enjoyable for a lot of people is to see how caring these animals are to each other.
But even good moms can't do it alone. Peregrines wouldn't be here without the decades of work by ecologists, biologists, and birders who helped them beat extinction and are still looking out for them today. If you want to follow along with Annie and her family, we've got a link to the Cal Falcons feed in the video description.